Hello and welcome to my video tutorial series RPG in the Box. I'm Carsten, and in this episode I would like to show you how to create your first character. To do so, we have to create a new resource. So click the New Resource tab and then select Character from the drop-down menu. For each resource of the Voxel Editor, like characters, objects and tiles, it's important to choose the grid size. The grid size is the grid which you can where you can place your voxels. If you choose a big grid size by default, you can bring more detail to your objects, but if you use a small grid size by default, you can build several large objects like a big table which spans over several tiles. I use a grid size of a width, height and depth of 16 voxels per tile and wall and block. And for characters, I use a 50% higher grid size, so 16 times 16 times 24 for characters. So I call my character Rex and press the OK button. We are in the so-called Voxel Editor. That's the grid where we can edit our characters. With the right mouse button, you can rotate your grid. With the middle mouse, you can drag it. And with the left mouse button, you can interact with the grid. There you can choose your width, height, and depth by sliders. The minimum is 6 to 32, and the height is 6 to 48. So I choose 16 to 16 and a height of 24 voxels for my character. In the lower right, you can define your viewport. Standard is the front, but you can also choose back, left, top, bottom, or other things. And it's important to keep the orientation and the angle of your model. To the left, we have our context menu. There we have the model tools where we can edit our model and the model properties where we can set properties for our model and set variables. In the model tools, we have attach place voxel with short key F1. There we can attach voxels. With F2, we can paint voxels. Then we have delete voxels with F3. And we have change color or replace color with F4. Additionally, we have move voxel with F5, select voxel F6, pick color F7, and attach point F8. There we can define attach point to attach other models to our model. Additionally, we have the modes. We have the box mode, the voxel, and the face mode. With the box mode, we can define corners to drag a cube inside our voxel editor. With alternative key plus set, we can erase it or undo it. Additionally, we have the redo and the undo button to the top, in the top navigation bar. With the voxel mode, I can edit freely in the grid and attach voxels, and with the face mode, I can select a surface to raise that by one level. Directly below, we have the rotate button to rotate our model. Then we can mirror it by the mirror button, and we can apply new colors by the apply palette button. The section below I will explain in a later episode. So if we go down, we can choose predefined colors from color sets. There are predefined palettes to use. And we can define our own palette by copying existing palette and give it a name. So I call it custom. Now I can define my own colors. So I can press the right mouse button, then select the color from the color bar or from the color field or input over the RGB values or the hex value and press OK. So my color is now in the palette. Per palette, you can define up to 256 colors. To draw my model, I select the Apply Voxel tool with the box mode and my color, and I will begin with the first voxel in the grid and set the feet of my character. By right mouse button, I can set my view, and with a pressed mouse wheel, and now we attach the legs, then the body, and my character also should have a tail. Oops, pressing alternate set to redo it. We attach the body and left arm and right arm and the left arm, and then the head. So I keep it simple. It's just for showing purpose. So, okay. And then I will attach two teeth. And then I use the color tool to paint a nose. Then I will give him eyes and a pupil. No, more to the front. That's okay. To save, press Alt S or use the save button and save often and regularly to don't lose anything. If you make changes like this, you see a asterisk in front of your model name. If you don't save, then you lose everything. If you come back to the main menu from another menu, you see the recently used model, so you can use it. Additionally, in the left side, you see your character. You can double-click it to open them. With right-click, you can position your tool and can work on your character for more details. So now it's up to you. I position my camera, copy Rex to your space, or build another character of your wishes. But our character can do nothing except moving, but without animation, we have to do all that from scratch. In the next episodes, we will build tiles and then a map to use it together with our character to play the game the first time, together with a startup script. Then we will come to animation stuff. I will explain the details of animations and additional the how shaders work, so we can bring more details to our objects, characters, or tiles. If you enjoyed the episode, give me thumbs up, stay tuned, and I would be very excited about your subscription. See you in the next episodes. Bye!